So we're here at the ITU in Geneva, and we're at the Machine Learning and 5G workshop, and I'm very pleased to be joined by Slawomir Stanczak, who is also the chairman of the newly formed Machine Learning and 5G focus group. Slawomir, welcome, and thank you very much indeed for joining us here today.
Thank you for inviting me. It's a pleasure to be here and to have an interview with you.
Pleasure. So can you please explain to our viewers, you know, what are some of the advances in machine learning and what are some of the applications that are most useful to the ICT industry?
Okay, so many methods in machine learning was invented in the 80s, 70s, so they are not so new. And there was some there have been some advances in the context of deep neural networks. But I think that the most important thing, I mean, that happened in recent years is that we have now computational power, and then also we have access to the data. You know, there is no machine learning without data, and this is what has changed. And then you know, enabled you know now this boom and push to this to this field.
Mm-hmm. And you know, what are some of the most promising opportunities and challenges as well for operators, but also for different verticals like the auto industry, for example?
Okay, so we are mainly talking about 5G, you know, the next generation of wireless networks. And what is new about 5G when compared to 4G, that we will have the so-called verticals. You know, car manufacturers and things like this. So not only network operators, but you know, vertical industry. And so it means that you know, 5G networks will have to enable new applications. And so it includes, for example, ultra reliable communications or massive access. So you have you know, massively deployed sensors. And then, you know, this means, for example, you know, increased overhead, protocol overhead. And then it means also that you have a lot of uncertainty in the network. And here, the problem is that, you know, what we do right now is that we try to estimate all this unknown parameters. And then if we continue to do this in future, then probably you know the solutions. I mean, if we proceed to do this in the future, then the solution wouldn't be efficient. And then here, machine learning can help to, you know, to increase you know efficiency and to enable new applications.
And speaking of machine learning, I know you're working on a machine learning project at the Fraunhofer Institute. Can you say a few words about this project?
Okay, so I am the head of the wireless communications and network department at Fraunhofer Heinrich Hess Institute in Berlin, and also I am professor at TU Berlin. So I work in the area of machine learning, but only in connection with wireless communications or communication networks. So I am not expert in you know in say in machine learning in general, like you know, data mining or what companies like Google and Facebook do. So that's why just you know, for me, machine learning is just you know key ingredient you know to enable some applications and some say and to improve efficiency of mobile networks. This you know our projects, you know, are not you know like you know. Machine learning, pure machine learning projects. It's just always it's about you know how to apply machine learning to problems in wireless networks.
And you know you're also the new chairman of the new machine learning 5G focus group at ITU. What are some of the challenges that the focus group will address? Some of the goals of the focus group, and how might the focus group help the discipline to advance in the years going forward?
Yes, I mean, we have some interesting players there. I mean, in this area of network operators, network vendors, and service providers. And the focus group is not about research. It's so the goal, I mean, the main goal of the focus group is to identify standardization gaps. Okay, the question is what needs to be standardized in this area. And also, we can also identify research gaps And then another important topic is just related to data formats. I mean, we have to clarify, you know, which data needs to be collected. How do we need to proceed the data process the data in the network? Or question, you know, about the quality of the data and things like this. This is, you know, the goal of the focus group, and this is what we are going to discuss.
Well, it sounds very interesting, and I'd like to wish you the best of luck with the workshop and the focus group. And thank you very much indeed for your time.
Thank you very much.